Hello and welcome to the Griffin News. I'm your anchor, Christopher Civil. We start off today's broadcast with exciting news. Chestnut Hill College is featured in an upcoming documentary. The documentary is titled Urban Trinity, The Story of Catholic Philadelphia. 6ABC is hosting the film tonight at 7 p.m. and will repeat on Sunday, September 27th at midnight. The three-part film will focus on the origins of Catholicism in Philadelphia, as well as traditions, challenges, and unique Catholic communities. The Sisters of St. Joseph, most notably Sister Maria Koska Lauge, is featured in the documentary. Chestnut Hills College's sprint football team suited up for the first time ever last Saturday, hosting Princeton in a historic matchup. Princeton, a team who hasn't won a conference game since 1999, found themselves playing from behind as the Griffins quickly turned their inaugural game into a blowout in front of a full house at Plymouth White Marsh Stadium. Stay tuned for sports analyst Christian Hernandez and Matthew Owens for a breakdown of the game later in this broadcast. The CHC bookstore is reminding students that unsold textbooks are being returned to publishers soon. On October 1st, this return process will begin. The bookstore encourages students to let them know if any books need to be kept. We'll take a break from the news and send it over to Jada Zabala with a look at this week's upcoming weather. Jada.
Thank you, Chris. The forecast for today shows partly cloudy skies with a high of 76 and a low of 55 degrees. Looking at tomorrow, skies will be mostly cloudy with the high being 74 and the low being 55 degrees. If you're going to the Pope's Parade Sunday, you can expect a high of 70 degrees and partly cloudy skies pair with a low of 57 degrees. Monday will be warmer with the high being 78 degrees and the low 59 degrees. Tuesday is going to be partly cloudy with a high of 82 degrees and a low of 60 degrees. Wednesday, we'll start with a.m. showers and a high of 79 and a low of 56 degrees. Thursday remains humid and cloudy, but the high drops to 73 degrees and the low is a cool 51 degrees. I'm Jada Zabala, and this was your local weather for the week. We'll be back with Chris and the news after these quick messages.
Students at Chestnut Hill College are going green. Recycle bins are now available for use throughout the college campus. Students are encouraged to recycle paper, plastic, cans, and more. Part of Chestnut Hill's drive to go green includes the new addition of solar trash compactors. The new trash cans result in more storage and less trash pickups. Solar cells on top of the bins produce enough energy to run these new compactors. Now it's your turn to make a difference. Help Chestnut Hill College go green and correctly recycle and dispose of your trash. Together, we can make a difference.
Chestnut Hill College provides its students with free transportation that is open to all campus Griffins. The shuttle transports students to SEPTA train stations in Chestnut Hill, Sugarloaf on Germantown Avenue, and different stores in Plymouth Meeting, including the Plymouth Meeting Mall and the Metroplex. You can catch the Chestnut Hill shuttle every 25, 35, and 50 minute mark of every hour. So if you're looking to take a trip, why not choose the Chestnut Hill shuttle?
Students at Chestnut Hill College are getting physically fit in the newly remodeled gym. Over the summer, gym renovations created new workout opportunities for students. A new lifting station was placed on the first floor. This includes areas to lift, squat, do pull-ups, and bench press. Down the center of this new station includes a monkey bar set. The second floor of the gym is now 100% cardio with the addition of two rowing machines, two lateral ellipticals, and three treadmills. Students are encouraged to check out the gym and get familiar with the new equipment. In clubs and activities news, members of the Chestnut Hill College community gathered in Sir Jenny Arena on Wednesday to play in the annual Students vs. Faculty and Staff basketball game. Contesting for three periods, the students came away with a 51-41 victory. Reggie Robinson, Jeff Jean, and basketball club president Andrew Conboy led the students to the win. On Sunday, September 27th at 3 p.m., there will be a Mass in Carlino Chapel, as well as a live stream of the Papal Mass from the Benjamin Franklin Parkway. On Wednesday, September 30th, from 2 p.m. to 3 o'clock p.m., Fun at One Pope Mission and Legacy Celebration will take place in Student Activities Office, SJ349. Thursday, October 1st, CHC is hosting La Voz Latina and Chartwell's Present Spanish-Inspired Lunch from 11 to 1 p.m. in the cafeteria. In passport news, on Monday, September 28th, Student Success will be hosting a passport event on time management and study skills in room 223 Martino Hall. On Tuesday, September 29th, CHC will hold a passport event on Doing the Laundry, Dirty Shoes, Leadership Lessons from Pope Francis by Chris Lonely in the East Parlor from 2 to 3 p.m. On October 1st from 3 to 5 p.m., the Psychology Club will be holding a viewing and discussion of the movie American Psycho. Now let's send it over to Griffin News sports analyst Christian Hernandez and Matthew Owens with a closer look at recent sports news.
Hello, I'm Christian Hernandez.
And I'm Matthew Owens.
Now let's take a look at two previous games of the last week. Let's start off with men's soccer. The Chestnut Hill men's soccer team faced off against the University of the District of Columbia on September 9th at Victory Field No. 1. The 0-2 Griffins were looking to post their first win of the 2015 season. We skip to the UDC's Elio Hernandez's direct kick at the 21st minute, where junior goalkeeper James Jackson makes an incredible save on the volley by No. 4, Victor Furio. On to the 32nd minute, Musa Traore sends the ball through the 18-yard box to connect with Mehdi Badash, who slightly redirects the ball for a 1-0 UDC lead. To the second half we go. After a throw-in by Chestnut Hill, the Griffins showcase masterful passing with a give-and-go started by senior midfielder Nicholas Jaffe, who then nets a returning flick pass by freshman forward Jason Burns to provide the equalizer. Burns attempts to give the Griffins the lead at the 63rd minute with a nifty run towards the box, but UDC's goalkeeper Lewis Connor makes a stellar save to thwart any offensive threat. Despite the defensive effort, Chestnut Hill would take the lead at the 71st minute when senior forward Juan Amaya creates an opportunity by avoiding the defender near the end line, passing it to Jaffe. Jaffe feeds forward Jason Doherty, who fires an opposite post shot, making the score 2-1. CHC would never look back and finish the scoring with another goal by Doherty at the 82nd minute. Time would expire, and the Griffins would give first-year head coach Julian Fernandez his first victory. Jackson finished the game with 5 saves on 6 shots on goal, as Chestnut Hill outshot their opponents 18-3 in the second half. Milestones were made in this contest as well. Doherty scored his first goal and recorded his first 2 points of his career, making him the first rookie with a multi-goal game since Charles O'Connell in 2013 when he accomplished that feat against Wilmington University. With their individual performances, Juan Amaya and Nicholas Jaffe are currently tied for second place, with 2007 graduate Michael Cush on the all-time assist leaderboard in program history with 9, behind the mark set by 2006 graduate Mike Devine with 17.
Now, let's take a look at Sprint Football versus Princeton. The Chestnut Hill Sprint Football team launched their inaugural season with a contest against the Princeton University Tigers. The first drive of the game set the tone for how the afternoon would play out, as the Griffins forced a 3-and-out to begin the game. On the very next play, a botched snap allowed the Griffins to secure great field position. On 4th-and-4, quarterback Reggie Robinson connected with wideout Joshon Perez for the first score of the game. After making the extra point, the Griffins took a 7-point lead. With 5 minutes left in the first quarter, cornerback Kadeem Pankey picked off Princeton quarterback's Cowden and returned it 36 yards to the Princeton 33. The Griffins would capitalize on Pankey's takeaway as running back Theo McBurnett would fight through the line and make his way into the end zone to put his team up by 2 scores. Princeton did not roll over as Cowden threw a 32-yard touchdown before the end of the first quarter. But nothing could stop the Griffins on this historic day as they marched downfield and scored the third touchdown on Robinson's 11-yard pass to Dormarie Hill. The Griffins' defense seemed impenetrable as Princeton's quarterback Cowden gave away the ball for the second time when Marquise Watson picked off the Tigers' third down pass. On their last drive of the first half, the Griffins scored again when Robinson dialed up Hill for a 58-yard touchdown pass. The Griffins led the Tigers 28-7 at the half. Chestnut Hill continued to pour it on as running back DeSante Callis marched his way into the end zone on a 41-yard rush. The next Griffin drive ended in another touchdown when Theo McBurnett took on most of the Tiger defense and punched in an 8-yard run. Princeton just couldn't buy a break as their next possession ended in a repetitive manner. You probably guessed it, another interception, this time by Floyd Bennett. Chestnut Hill's run game did not discriminate as Kevin Taylor's 3-yard touchdown made him the third Griffin to rush for a touchdown, putting his team up by 6 scores. When time expired, the scoreboard read 48-13 in favor of our Griffins, capping off the first victory in Chestnut Hill's Sprint football program's history. Reginald Robinson completed 11 passes for 192 yards and 3 touchdowns on the day. DeSante Callis was the game's leading rusher with 128 yards, 1 touchdown, and wideout Dumery Hill had a big day as he had 6 receptions for 111 yards and 2 touchdowns. And that is all for the Griffins Sports Report for this week.
I'm Christian Hernandez.
And I'm Matthew Owens.
Thank you for watching.
The Griffin News will now be accepting announcements from clubs and activities as well as anyone holding an event at Chestnut Hill College. Your event will be advertised during our weekly broadcast, thus serving as an outlet for you and your to gain attendance at your events. If you have an announcement and you would like to be, it to be broadcasted, bring it to Devlin Production Suite in Martina 211 or email it to Griffin News producer Clayton B. Allen at allenc1@chc.edu. That wraps up our broadcast. Once again, I'm Christopher Civil. From all of us here, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.